So the next topic is lack of memory property of geometric distribution. You need to write the statement also. In some cases statement will be given to you. Here the statement is, you need to consider a geometric variable. What is the parameter of a geometric distribution? P. Let us consider x as a geometric variable with the parameter p. And here we are going to discuss about the waiting time. As you know that geometric distribution indicates the number of failures before reaching the first success. Okay? Before reaching the first success, the number of failures occurred is, if you take as a variable, that is going to represent the geometric variable here. Now, if you consider an event E, at one of the times t is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, so on infinity, the waiting time x has a geometric distribution with parameter 3. Here we are going to prove that the waiting time distribution is also a geometric distribution. So that is p probability of x here indicates the waiting time distribution. Waiting time, not waiting time distribution. So we are calling that x as a variable. Suppose event E is can occur any one of the times t is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. So if E has not occurred before k, let us suppose that event E has not occurred before the time k, then we can define y is equal to x minus k as the waiting time here. Then you need to prove that the conditional distribution y is equal to t given x greater than or equal to k is equal to p into q power t. All this is statement itself, the entire part stands for statement here. What you need to prove? Probability that y is equal to x minus k, x stands for the waiting time which has not occurred before time t, given that x greater than t is a geometric variable. So let us try, what is given here? Given x follows geometric distribution with parameter p. Then what is p of x? P into q power t. In place of x we are considering here t. Generally we write that as p into q power x. Here I wrote p into q power t as we are dealing with waiting times. What you need to prove? You need to prove that p of y is equal to t given x greater than or equal to k is equal to p into k power t. You need to prove that. So I think this can be written as p of y is equal to t given x greater than or equal to t can be written as p of y greater than or equal to t given, I'll explain you this. Here we are writing y is equal to t. This can be written as, if you consider the interval from 0 to infinity here, if we have here, you need to find out exactly at the time t. You need to find out the probability at y is equal to t. This can be taken as the difference of, if you consider here somewhere k, okay? So this will be t plus k. So y is equal to t can be written as y greater than t, means from here the entire one, minus y greater than t plus k. The difference of these two, y greater than or equal to t minus y greater than or equal to t plus k, is going to give y is exactly at y is equal to t. So to calculate this, you should find out these two. Again, all these are given. These are nothing but the conditional probabilities. Let us calculate the first term, which is nothing but p of a given b is nothing but p of a intersection b by p of b. So what is y here? Y in turn defined in terms of x as y is equal to x minus k. Let us replace this with y is nothing but x minus k greater than or equal to t intersection x greater than or equal to k by p of x greater than or equal to k. I'll rewrite the last statement again. We are calculating p of y greater than or equal to t given x greater than or equal to k, which we got this as p of x minus k greater than or equal to t intersection x greater than or equal to k by p of x greater than or equal to k. So you can shift this to the RHS. It becomes x greater than or equal to t plus k intersection x greater than or equal to k by p of x greater than or equal to k. So I think it is k, t plus k is more than k. Means if x greater than 3 and x greater than 2, by clubbing these two simply we can write as x greater than 3. We have x greater than t plus k intersection x greater than t plus k. So as t plus k is more than this, we can write this as x greater than or equal to t plus k by t of x greater than or equal to k. This is the first part of the inequality which we need to find. So x greater than or equal to t plus k. Again we are going to use what is p of a less than x less than b. We are going to write as sigma a to b p of x. If it is a discrete variable, the geometric is a discrete one. Whenever we have some of the lower limit is not given, means we will consider that as minus infinity or the range of the given variable. If the upper limit is absent, we are going to take that as infinity. So what is the numerator here? P of x greater than or equal to t plus k. As this geometric is a continuous discrete variable, you start with sigma. X greater than or equal to t plus k is same as t plus k less than or equal to x. So here the upper limit is missing, so we'll write that as infinity. The lower limit is t plus k. Again, x greater than or equal to t plus k is same as t plus k less than or equal to x. So this is the lower limit. As the upper limit is missing, the upper limit of the geometric distribution is infinity, which is nothing but p into q power t. So p can be taken out. T plus k to infinity q power t. Okay, so if you put t plus k here, the starting limit is this p into, in place of t l plus q power t plus k, next one is q power t plus k plus 1, it's an infinite series. P into q power t plus k, if you take out common, you'll get 1 plus q plus so on. It is the general expansion we use in geometric is 1 minus q whole power minus 1. 1 minus q is p. So these two will get cancels and you'll get q power t plus k. You got p of x greater than or equal to t plus k as q power t plus k. You got p of x greater than or equal to t plus k as q power t plus k. I think similarly you'll get p of x greater than k means you'll get q power k. As you have t plus k here, in the power you got q power t plus k. Here you are going to get q power k. So let us write this as equation number 1. So in the equation number 1, we are calculating the first part. In that first part also you have a numerator and denominator. So what is p of y greater than or equal to k given x greater than or equal to k? The numerator you got as q power t plus k. The new denominator is q power k. So you got this as q power t. Power t. So this is nothing but the first part of the equation number 1. What is the second part of equation number 1? P of y greater than or equal to t, given x greater than or equal to k, you got as q power t. How much you will get? P of y greater than or equal to t plus k, given x greater than or equal to k, as q power k plus 1 plus t by t plus 1. So from what is the equation number 1? P of y is equal to t, given x greater than or equal to k, is equal to q power t minus q power t plus 1, q power t into 1 minus q, which is nothing but q power t into p. This is what you need to prove. Thank you.